Good morning and welcome to Jindivick. This is Broughton Hall, the garden of Broughton Hall in Jindivick, Australia. And we're just leaving winter and we're coming into spring. We've already had lots of daffodils up. There's quite a few unusual daffodils starting to come up now. So I just wanted to show you the garden at this time of year because we're not open to the public at this time of year normally. So it's really interesting to see it just in its sort of bare stages, just coming into some kind of activity. So the beginning of spring's a really hopeful time. You can see things starting to move and all the plants are starting to resurrect themselves. So it's a really, really good time. So I won't talk too much through this video, but I will show you just a few things that I'd like to point out. So I'll grab the camera and we'll walk through. So this is our, obviously our pond and parterre area, the upper terrace, and the trees in the distance are cherry trees, so they're bare, but a few weeks time they'll be all white with flowers. It's Pieter Ronsard, first bloom. These are little miniature cyclamen, little species, coombe cyclamen. Pink daffodils. Very beautiful. First leaves of a maple. It's the colour that everybody tries to achieve in their gardens at this time of year. That beautiful lime green. Another daffodil. First flowers of a peony rose. It's not really a rose, it's a peony. Looks like a rose. More beautiful daffodils. There's so many varieties. Sonchus, yellow sonchus. These beautiful daffodils. They're like an egg yolk colour. Quite amazing. Tulips, not yet in flower. These little miniature daffodils with their ears back. These are rose beds that'll be full of blooms in about a month, 6 weeks. Another daffodil. Beautiful white or creamy colour. Just quietly flowering away. Central axis, central steps. Hedge. It's looking down to the rock outcrop. These little miniature daffodils are beautiful. Little stars, masses of them. They're quite amazing too. Just lovely. And these little ones, very special little pink ones. Happy little things. And they pop up under all these roses. All facing the sun. They're not daffodils. Wonder if you noticed. Magnolia. And then these little daffodils here with their ears back. They've got a bit of attitude going on. And these are forget-me-nots, but they're white forget-me-nots. So they're forgiven for being white, because the blue ones are the more common one. There's a few blues in there still. I'll just show you this beautiful place to sit. Good views from here. More daffodils. I'll go and check those ones out. Path leads up to the yellow garden. We probably won't get to that in this video, but I'll show you next time. This leads down to the pink garden. And we've got masses of daffodils here. Pheasant eyes, these ones. And we've picked thousands and they're still here. There's the seat we had before. So this seat overlooks the pink garden. So we're in the pink garden now. So once these daffodils go, then all the pink flowers start. There are tulips coming up in here. And amongst that. More daffodils up there. Some pink ones just here. Very happy. These little things are nice too. Still a couple that haven't been eaten. Those ones. Some cows enjoying the sun. a type of daphne, I think, also yellow, which the bees love. Helianthus minor. These little baby ones here, but there's not too many that haven't been eaten by snails today, but anyway, they're at the end of their section. This is rosemary. This is the courtyard to the cottage, the garden room. That's the pink garden up there. And there's the garden room. So we'll walk along here. These roses on these columns, you'll see in a month or two. It's lavender, and a few tulips out, a few pink tulips coming out. They're planted all through there, so that'll be beautiful in a couple more weeks. And Bor in the distance. This euphorbia's got the most stunning colour, that lovely lime green. That's the flower. And this is the rock outcrop here. It's a beautiful idea by David Musker, who designed it, planted it, looked after it, did everything. And that, look, it leads into the Japanese section. And that goes up into those, that round hedge that we were in before. Colonnade. I'll just walk us down on the outcrop. Around that flagpole there's a circle of tulip trees. They're still dormant, but they're all budding. I can see a few of them budding. These blue cactuses and palms and cassonias, different plants. They blend in so well, these beautiful palms. This one here, lovely. I'll just quickly take you to the Japanese garden, just so you can see that in winter, late winter. Because because once this flowers and starts getting leaves, it'll be completely different next time. Got hellebores here, daffodils, cyclamen. And these coral bark maples, they have a red bark. I don't know if you can see that against the sky. Very beautiful colour, stunning colour. And a little geezo in the distance there. It's protecting everybody that comes here. So far it's done a great job. Look at this Mahonia, how beautiful. It's just so beautiful, that flower. And they go, they're my stunning autumn colours when the leaves turn. Little hellebores. They come in amazing colours. More here. Whites. Okay, now we're back in this section here. So that's not all the garden, that's probably half of the garden, but it gives you a bit of an idea what it all looks like in the winter and coming into spring. And today's such a beautiful day. I thought I have to share this because it's not fair, we're all in lockdown. And just to have something to show someone or to share is really wonderful. Hope you have a great day.